Hey, I'm Janelle. This is To DIY For, and as you can see, I've kind of got my DIY space a little more decorated and a little more functional. I didn't do a DIY for this, but if you're wondering how I put this together, quickly, it's just a wooden dowel, and these are curtain rod holders. I just bought a curtain rod at the dollar store. I put them in the wall, holds the dowel perfectly, bought a couple of S-hooks, and now I have some of those tools that I use regularly behind me, and it kind of looks nice as well. Something else I did for the space, though, was create a dry erase calendar, and I DIY'd this with something from the thrift store, so it's really cheap to do, and it's going to help keep me organized and on top of things for DIYs to come. So let me show you how I did that.
So what you're looking for is a huge frame. This was, I believe, like a poster frame. So it is just a piece of kind of plexiglass, I guess, right there. And it's gonna work perfect for dry erase markers. They'll work on normal glass as well. The frame was a little rusty. I only got it for $5 at the thrift store though, or not rusty, but chipped up. So I'm painting the frame there black again. Now with this back piece, you're gonna wanna cover it with some paper. You can do whatever color you like. I would suggest not something with a heavy pattern. It's going to be difficult to read your writing. So I just have some plain brown paper there, and on the right hand side I'm putting a piece of white cardstock, and that's going to be for notes. So next you need to draw out your calendar, measure it properly so that all your boxes are the right size and you can fit a full calendar there. I'm drawing out my lines using some funky washi tape that I had kicking around. You can use any tape, or you can simply just draw these lines on if you like. So once your calendar is done, essentially everything we're putting on here is things that aren't going to change. For example, the days of the week. So I'm filling that out. Don't put a month on there. Don't put numbers on. That's going to change. And then there on the right side, I'm just putting notes for that section. So then you just basically pop it back in place. Make sure that plexiglass is all clean, and you have yourself a new dry erase calendar. Now, on a quick side note, this is something I also created for the space as decor. I actually made that myself. So that's a photo I took when I was in Panama. I love it so much. I put the words on it using Snapchat filter, and then I just saved it. I went to Walmart and I printed it out in a very large size and in the poster form, and it cost me $5. So instead of buying a print, you can make your own as an option for some decor. So here's my calendar. Just dry erase markers work on this. They wipe off real easy, and I'm sorry for the glare.
So as you can see, it's very easy to make, and you can customize it to your own space, and it is way cheaper than purchasing one or getting like a piece of plexiglass. I looked into doing that and it was way too expensive, so this is a really great alternative. If you do enjoy this DIY, please give the video a like, and if you make it for yourself, I'd love to see some photos of your DIYs at home, so follow me on Instagram and on Twitter. Tag me in any of those photos so I can check out your DIYs, and don't forget to come back next week for a new video on Wednesday. Cheers!